Well, I must say it's a great honour to be working with you. And I really don't know much about you, Sarah. So can you tell me something about your life, your early life? I mean, have you always lived in Madeira?
I was born in Madeira. I was brought up in Madeira. English side of the family, Portuguese side of the family all kind of came together in this little being. And I've thoroughly enjoyed my life here in Madeira.
I think you're right. I think it's a beautiful island. But which of your parents was English and which was Portuguese?
So my mum was English.
Right.
Is English. And my dad was Portuguese.
Madeira. All right. And where does the talent come from, would you say? Does it come from your mum or your dad?
No, my mum sings in the church beautifully. Uh-huh. But other than that, no. My dad was a singer, quite a well-renowned Portuguese singer.
Right. What was his name?
Sergio Borges.
Oh, right. Okay.
Yeah, and they had what they used to call the Portuguese Beatles.
Right.
And that was the Conjunto Académico João Paulo.
Okay.
So, I guess I've always grown up with music being somewhere in the vicinity.
Is he the only one of your family that looked musical? Or?
No, my uncle is one hell of a pianist, especially within jazz.
Oh, right.
It's his kind of area of expertise.
Oh, right.
And he's stunning.
Yeah,
really is.
I think I saw some of his work on YouTube.
Jorge Borges.
Oh, yes, I remember it.
Yeah.
He was very... He used to favour a particular jazz musician.
Thelonious Monk, who is also amazing and one of my particular favourites as well.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you ever sing any of those?
I did in one of his tribute concerts, actually.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh.
No, as an honour.
But how long ago was that? Because, I mean, you...
That, well, with my uncle, that was in November last year.
Really?
Yeah, so quite recent.
Oh. And your dad, how did he also perform in Madeira, or did he go to mainland?
Very much so. They started off basically in high school.
Oh,
so
really?
They formed like a high school band.
Right.
And it really picked up.
Right.
I mean, just the charisma that they demonstrated took them a hell of a long way.
Yeah.
And then just their natural talent. They came up with music that was different in Portugal for the time, which eventually took them to the mainland and to different other places as well.
So he performed on the mainland?
He went to the Eurovision Song Contest.
Really?
But he won to represent Portugal, but then Portugal pulled out at the last minute and he didn't get to go to the international.
He could have been either new point or many points.
Oh, many points, I'm sure.
So do you think that's where you get the talent?
Think so. If you can say that those kind of things are genetic, then that would be the route.
Mm-hmm.
But I guess just the influences. I always grew up hearing music at home.
Right.
My first birthday and my second and my third were at the casino.
Really?
Seeing my dad play. Yeah, so this tiny little baby.
Oh, how sweet.
Got taken into the casino, like showroom.
You don't have any pictures of that?
Oh.
Anywhere? Nothing around?
Don't know. Maybe.
The family album.
Maybe.
So that's where you've been, and now you're pretty popular here, I think. I mean, everywhere I go, I people know you.
I do quite well for myself, I must say. I've been lucky with the people I've met throughout, like, this music business here in Madeira, which is, you know, very quite close. Everybody kind of knows who each other are.
Yeah.
And I've never had too many issues in getting work, which in the music business is like insane.
Especially with COVID.
Oh, especially with COVID. That's a whole new ballpark.
How did you manage?
Well, we were doing what we call quarantine sessions for a start.
Uh-huh.
And those were just basically opportunities they'd give us to practice our craft at home.
Mm. Oh, right.
So we'd record it, we'd do live Facebook videos, and just things like that.
And it worked.
Yeah.
But now it's all kind of over, not over, but you're getting a lot of work now.
Within, like here in Madeira, from July onwards, I remember because I took a little holiday and I came back and everything just exploded.
Yeah.
I got myself involved in teaching music.
Oh, really?
It's a little local kind of school/association.
Mm-hmm.
Very casual.
What's the
learning.
Name?
Gig.
Gig.
G-I-G.
G-I-G.
Gig.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I got involved in that. At the same time, the bars, the hotels, the restaurants, they started calling again.
Of course.
And then suddenly I looked into my agenda and it was just ooh, packed as I hadn't seen it in well over a year.
Yeah. Yeah, a lot of Brits came in on planes as well.
Yeah.
So, but you have an enormous repertoire of standards, jazz standards and pop standards. I mean, I came along to one of those sessions and you were 1 minute playing Ed Sheeran and the next minute you were playing a very old Ella Fitzgerald number and Ava Cassidy. And I mean, how many songs could you sing?
Oh, no idea.
Because
you end up by always putting some new songs in and then taking some out that you don't really feel anymore, which happens.
Do you write your own as well?
I do, but I have a bit of a commitment issue with my own songs.
Really?
In the term that I start them, I get really into it, and then I get, sometimes, you know, when you hit a wall, and instead of trying to break through that wall, I go and start something else.
Another wall.
I start building another wall, which I also then can't go across.
Okay.
So it's kind of that little battle.
So you've arrived at the ripe old age of 20-something.
Thank you.
And,
keep the ladies.
and no album yet.
No.
So how do you feel about this one that's coming?
I'm excited. I think it's finally giving me that push to actually carry something through.
Yeah, yeah.
And because... it's awful to admit this of yourself, but I have been very lazy in that respect.
Well, I wouldn't have said that.
No, up to now, COVID did something funny to me. It kind of woke me up.
Right.
That feeling of you actually have to stop and that not having anything to do just wasn't sitting right with me. Mm. And then I realised that I kind of did that to myself on a regular basis anyway.
Oh, I see.
And it took actually a colleague, he's a radio presenter, and just with some friends.
What's his name?
I'm Richard Gelbert.
Okay.
And we were just chatting and he was going, oh, so I'm going to bring you in, we've got stuff on. And I'm like, well, actually, I'm not working on anything at the moment. It was about less than a year ago.
Mm-hmm.
I hadn't met you then. And he just said, oh, yeah, well, you know what your problem is, don't you? And I said, no. Oh, you're really lazy.
Oh.
And it's like, oh.
Well, let me give
it's
you
like,
some...
I want to complain at you, I want to get mad, but you're kind of right, I have been getting a bit lazy. Because you get into the hotels here in Madeira, and you've got your schedule a week, okay, so here I'm here, here I'm here. There's no change, you get into that bit of a monotony, but it's comfortable. You're receiving well, you can pay your bills, and you just don't feel the need to go above and beyond.
Mm.
Except for now, I do.
You
and
do.
And that's
you do
kind
feel
of
like
routine. It's just
on.
Not enough anymore.
No. Well, this album looks good. I mean, I've seen some of the tracks, and I think it's going to be a knockout. But that's only my opinion, because I wrote some of the lyrics.
Fair enough, fingers crossed, not at all biased, but...
No, but I think it's as I say, a great privilege for me to be working with... You have a great talent, and I... You know what? I think Portuguese talent in music is amazing, and I'm considered... constantly puzzled by why they aren't more on the world stage, you know? I mean, okay, we've had Marisa.
Yeah,
could say
I guess
she's on the
quite recognisable.
But that's on, you know, you could count those people on one hand. And I think it's time that Portugal really entered the world stage. And to be honest, I think you have a chance of doing that. You know?
I'll give it my best shot.
Give it your best shot, baby. Thank you very much. Very interesting to talk to you.
Thank you.